Thank you very much. Good morning, friends. Good morning, friends. Respected Chairman Dr. H.C. Watts, my faculty colleagues this side, various senior members of the team, Dr. Kaul, Vineet Watts, who is a member of the management committee, Dean Indira Bharadwaj, Anuradha Jain, Principal, Supriya Madam, Pavan Saloni. Indeed, it's a really very pleasant day, very fortunate day for every one of us that we are organizing this conclave, which is HR Conclave called Mantra 2019. And it is important from two very important point of view. One, I'm sure you are all aware, we are starting in the Indian democracy, the election starting today. You are aware? So it's the first phase of the election starting today, so it is very important. Why I mentioned this? Because in a democratic India, politics becomes very important. In fact, in any country, it becomes important. But for us so, because policy and business and other issues which are related to politics, they become very, very important. Second thing which is very important and why this conclave has become so important is because we have people from the HR area, HR field, thought leaders who really try to show the torch as to how we should try to hunt for the talent. We try to acquire the talent in different fields from different areas. And we have, in fact, those that galaxy of eminent personality. Starting with very important person, in fact, we have got Mr. Sanjay Banga, who is in fact the chief guest. Give a big, big hand, please. Give a big hand. I need not introduce Mr. Sanjay Banga, but I think his all the experience show as to what really he has done for the Tata Power. He is a very important personality, and being his gracious presence today, in fact, has really very important for us. So nice of you, sir. It's a extend a very hearty and warm welcome on behalf of the Institute. It's a very, very honored situation for us. We also have other speakers, once again, starting from Mr. Jain from NHPC. He's a director of personnel. It's very important, in fact, that he is with us, and he has a rich experience. Again, on behalf of the Institute, on behalf of every one of you, we extend a very hearty and warm welcome to you, sir. Indeed, it's a great pleasure. Mr. Manoj Bartwal, who is from the ONGC, a group at GM, and also he is looking after the head of the coordination. In fact, we extend a very hearty and warm welcome to him. He is a very important person because he is a training department and he looks after all the HR and other related issues. Sir, we extend a very hearty and warm welcome to you. To Mr. V.K. Singh, he belongs to the Power Grid. In fact, such an important, I'm sure you know it, as to Power Grid is an organization which is in the power sector, trying to relate to all those transmissions of the power, and that's very important. Sir, we extend a very hearty welcome to you too. It's a very important that you are having. In fact, it's our honor and privilege that you are here with us, and we are really trying to make yourself available and also speak to our students and interact with them as to what sort of a queries are. I must mention a few things about VIPS also. I'm sure you are all aware, but I think our guest may be something. A journey which we started in 2000, now we have come to a stage which is of 19 years, started with only one department called law, or one course with a law, but we got now six departments here, around 7,000 students, and our students are very important. In fact, they are the people who are bringing laurels to every one of us. And I think we have tried to show to them also, our guests, that the academic achievements and also the achievements in the field of practice in our students have been doing very well. It's not a question merely of the law department, it's also the other departments too. In fact, they are doing fantastically well. Therefore, VIPS is what really we stand today, what we get today, is because of the visionary effort of the founder and the chairman, Dr. S.C. Watts. Please give a big hand to him. He is present. I should be welcoming him on behalf of the Institute, though it is his Institute and we share his vision. But I think as a formal function, we should try to extend a hearty and warm welcome to him too. Because it is his efforts that we are, in fact, come to a stage where we are. But you know, and you are young guys, dil mange more. Hum log aa gaye kisi stage pe. लेकिन फिर भी मन करता है कुछ और हो. एंड देयर इज व्हाट आवर एस्पिरेशन लेवल इज वेरी वेरी हाई. वी वांट टू रीच हाइट्स, विच हाइट्स वी डू नॉट नो, बट वी आर ट्राइंग टू स्ट्राइव टूवर्ड्स दोज हाइट्स. एंड देयर इज व्हाट आवर एफर्ट इज इन दिस डायरेक्शन. Now, so this is what really, in all the departments of VIPS, we try to get into that. I'm now coming to the HR conclave, the theme which is what we have got it. I think there was a thinking. Thinking was very, I think, very concrete. In a way, sometimes we start discuss with our colleagues too, that management as a discipline, what is that we are doing it? It is an applied discipline, or is it a discipline that we really teach in the classrooms? Now, we too in the classrooms, I'm sure, and either. For example, you know, in the case of the medicine, you qualify as a medicine practitioner. You don't immediately become a successful doctor. Same thing happens with the management students also. You teach in the class. It does not mean that you have become a successful manager, which means whatever we impart knowledge in terms of the management, whether it's an undergrad level or at a postgraduate level, this has to be applied. Which means simple as we understand as an academician, management is an applied discipline. It is not knowledge for the sake of knowledge, rather it is a knowledge which has to be applied for solving the problems of the society. Now, which problems we have yet to take? There are a lot many problems of the society. Whether society we take individuals, or we take the organization, or society in general, or of the government, I think management knowledge has to get into that area where we are able to solve the problems of the society. And what is the goal? Simple goal. We should try to strive for betterment of the welfare of the people. Because solving the problem means what? It's not for solving for the sake of solving, but trying really to help them to have a better standard of living, better welfare of the people. That is what normally we as an academicians, my colleagues and I, we try really to discuss and debate how really we should try to get into that. Now, what is the way out we were trying to get into? Let's see the world around. What is the world we are facing today? And you know it, which I you know better. I'm sure our guests know much better than what we are. World of business has changed drastically. What it was earlier and what it is today is very, very different that we are having it. Which means very simple. A world which we are some 10 years ago, even 20 is very long enough. I will say 1991, when we got privatization and liberalization took place in India, that world and this world we talk about around 40 years or 40, 50 years. Now, that is a very different past we are saying. I'm talking about only 10 years before. Whatever the world was, today it has changed drastically. Which means what? To the education institution or to an academician, what does it mean? Simple it means. It means the skill set that we are trying to impart to our students is not relevant in that context, in the present day context. We are trying to impart knowledge to the students, which may not be relevant. Therefore, we need to be, and that is what I'm sure you must have heard a term called Industrial Revolution 4.0 or 4.0, as we say it. Industrial Revolution has taken shape, and it has really, what we say, these innovations are now the order of the day, and there's all around disruption which is taking place in the business. Whichever industry you take, there's no stability at all. That is what we are talking about. So it means what to us? We mean it's very simple. As an academician, as an institution, we need really to get into the area where we to impart skills to the students which are relevant today. And maybe which are relevant in the future. We do not know what future going to hold for us. We do not yet know it. Because future is something you can't predict. And word which is being used, and for students, I'm sure you must have heard it. My here all esteemed guests, they are all aware of it. Word is called VUCA. V-U-C-A. I'm sure you're aware. If not, remember it. VUCA is a term often used in the management circle. It is called volatility is there. Volatility. Uncertainty is there. Right? VUCA, there's a change which is taking place, complexity which is taking place, and there's an ambiguity which is taking place in the business. So four things are taking place of today's world. This is a volatile. I'm sure some of you may be interested in the stock market. I'm sure you must be watching and observing what a drastic, in fact, volatility happening in the stock market even now in the weeks or 2 weeks or before, or going to be there now. There's a volatility which is taking place. This is a complexity. We are uncertain. We do not know what is going to take place. And it's very difficult to interpret what we are going to do. So this is the world we are facing today. If this is the world, again, as a conceptualization, because we as an academician have to conceptualize, impart knowledge to our students, how really to get into that part of a thing? So we were discussing how to be there, be near to the industry. We have to be industry, because industry is changing much faster than what we are doing as academicians. Many times it is happening, in fact, most of the time. Put it this way, when I'm sharing one interesting incident, when I was in Lucknow, and this was 40 years ago, 84, 85, 86, when it started, in fact. We used to hear a term which is called what we teach in the classroom is not relevant for the industry in 86, 87, not relevant. Today also I'm hearing the same thing. What's there? Things are the same. We have tried more and more to fill up the gap. We are trying as an academician. It's not that we don't try it. We try it. But, you know, the change is so fast that we are not able to keep up with the pace of the change which is taking place in the industry or the business. That's what is happening. Now, in this sort of a situation, four important things have come out, and that's what I would like to mention it to you. Number one, there is a competition which has increased drastically. And competition is not only domestic, it is global competition which is there. And which we used to hear in our textbooks, this is called a cutthroat competition. Usually, really, you cut your throat of your competitor and that's going to take place. This, we see it every day happening in our society, in our business, this is what. Second is, customers have become, and you are all customers by chance, we all are customers. Our expectation level has gone up. And remember, he's not old customers, not simple customer like me, an aged person. No, you guys, right? Millennial, which we say. Young guys, your expectation level is much different than what our expectation is. We require stability, you want a change. And change every moment, you want to be very disturbing the whole style which is happening. So in this context, competition is there, there is a customer, and there is a, what we say, the quality consciousness and also the cost. So I won't be taking much time, but I must mention, these were the contexts in which we were thinking, why not we try to get in touch with the industry people, find out as to what do they look for it. Is classroom teaching sufficient? Because ultimately, you guys, the students, have to get employed somewhere. And if you have to get employed, we as an institute have to impart skills and knowledge and attitudes and values in a way which help you to get a job. And for you, you have to know which type of skills are required, which type of knowledge is required. Maybe we are not able to impart that knowledge. And that is why we thought it, we should try to have HR conclave so that we can listen from the horse's mouth. What do they look for? Ultimately, the recruit, they are the people who are there hunting the talent in the industry. It's not mainly from that, it's hunting it. They are looking for as to what really sort of a talent they are looking for. What are the type of things they look for in a new recruit, new person? So we thought it, we should try to have the HR conclave of this time. And we have invited, and our focus was more on, I should say, infrastructure, power and energy. Why? You may say, look here, we are BCom, BBA students or undergrad, we have nothing to do. No, not at all. I think you have everything to do because they are the infrastructure who are the backbone of the economy. You can have the latest version of your e-commerce, your Amazon, any other e-commerce business which we have it in the fashion today. But ultimately, who is going to have that? Infrastructure is a backbone of an economy. So if you understand the backbone, if your backbone is strong, I'm sure you will be able to flourish much better way. And that is why we thought it, let us focus on power and oil sector in the infrastructure. Power sector, I think we have all luminaries from the power sector. We go from the oil sector and oil extraction company, ONGC, Mr. Barthawal. And by chance, they are the richest companies. They are rich, yeah. They pay much more. They got funded. Each company itself got plenty of money. No other, even your Amazon.com, etc., they don't have that much money. But they have it. They silently collect money. And they have plenty of money. We thought it, why don't we listen to them and try to find it out? What do they look for? And that was our focus, that power and oil, we should try to have it. I thought it, I should try to tell you this. And finally, before I give my mic to our friends here, those who are managing all of our students, businesses have changed, but basics have remained the same. Simple, its basics are always the same, and they will remain the same. And I must quote one very interesting quote. Ishana vidyana tapo na danam jnanam na shilam na guno na dharma te marti loke bhuvibhar bhuta manush rupin maga sharanti. This was a simple slok I heard when I was a child. Simple. Ishana vidyana tapo na danam. At that time it was being said, jiske paas mein vidya nahi hai, jiske baad mein tap nahi hai, practice nahi karta, hard work nahi hai, jiske paas mein daan nahi hai, jise hum aap aajkal CSR bolte hain, philanthropy, daan nahi karta, jiske paas mein gyan nahi hai, applied knowledge nahi hai, shield nahi hai, modesty nahi hai, humility nahi hai, jiske paas mein aur anya gun nahi hai, jiske paas mein dharm nahi hai, they don't have a choice, they don't have a, in fact they can't differentiate between right and wrong. Yadi ye sab qualities kisi mein nahi hai, तो इस श्लोक में बताया है कि वो मनुष्य और पशु में क्या अंतर है. सेम इज ट्रू, इट वॉज सेम वॉज ट्रू अर्लियर, सेम इज ट्रू टूडे. आई एम श्योर द कंपनीज लुक फॉर दीज बेसिक क्वालिटीज विच दे आर देयर. आई एम श्योर मच मोर विल बी कमिंग एंड आई थॉट इट आई स्टार्ट विद दिस एंड आई वॉन्ट बी टेकिंग मच ऑफ योर टाइम बट आई मस्ट वंस अगेन वेलकम ऑन बिहाफ द इंस्टीट्यूट every one of you individually and collectively, and do share your questions whenever there's an opportunity you ask, and make it more interactive, because that is an opportunity for you to find out as to how you can really know what the industry looks for. With this, I thank you very much. I'm sorry, I said Rashmi was also, I welcome every one of you present here, so I missed out, and other colleagues. So thank you very much. Thanks a lot.